To coincide with the 10th anniversary of the September 11th attacks, the Field Museum in Chicago hosted the launch of Ground Zero 360. This is a unique exhibition that honors and remembers the victims of 9/11 in New York City. The exhibition features previously unpublished photos, treasured personal items from lost rescue workers, and fragments of granite and steel from the World Trade Center. It was created by Nicola McLean, an Irish photojournalist, and Paul McCormack, a former commanding officer of the New York City Police Department.
It was very, very emotional. It was a great turnout from the Chicago Police and Fire Department and the people of Chicago. We had the alderman, local alderman here, gave us a proclamation, and it was an inspiring day. It was brilliant, way better than we could have anticipated, and we're really happy that Chicago was the place where you opened it up here.
I promised myself that day that I would never, ever, ever forget what happened, and to me, the message that we want to bring to people is to never forget and always remember those who sacrificed so many.
The exhibition, which is also running in Ireland, captures the chaos, courage, and emotions of September 11th and recalls the experiences of people on that day.
Disbelief, shock, horror, and quite frankly, outrage that someone that could attack civilians in such a callous and despicable manner.
Visitors can see the American flag that flew over Ground Zero and hear the city's original emergency response radio calls on that morning.
Essential, is any part of that plane on the ground?
I'm not okay.
Uniforms, pictures, and medals of honor and valor are also on display, and personal objects have also been donated by families of some of the fallen rescue workers. Family members also attended the launch of the exhibition.
It's an honor for me to be here on behalf of my family and share with my children, and it's an honor for Brian, for his name and his face to be mentioned. I want people to know him, to see him, and to remember him as well as the others. It's important for people outside of New York to be affiliated with it, to see it, and to be a part of it. Yes, it is sad and it is scary, but it can happen at any time to anyone. And people should know that. It's important for them to see things on a personal level, and I think that will help memorialize and help the people who died be remembered.
A work colleague of Brian McDonnell, John McKenna, was clearly impressed by the exhibition.
It's very nice. I like how they brought out like the missing persons board here, you know, and they didn't just focus on first responders, they focus on everybody. It was nice. Nice to see. We were digging some of Brian's items up, as well as the family, so it's good to see, you know, especially his uniform again, it's kind of seeing that out with his name on it and stuff like that. You know, it means a lot. Guys like to see the unit being recognized, you know, for the work that they did, and just to remember the guys that we lost that day.
For many of those at the launch, it was a very moving occasion.
I like to see this. It hurts. It's good to see it. Actually, this is my brother, Chris. He worked for Cantor Fitzgerald. We lost him on 9/11. He worked in the North Tower on the 104th floor. And we knew that he was okay for a while because the phones where he was working, his trading firm, they were able to talk with people for a while, and a couple of people had cell phones. He was able to leave a message for my sister-in-law saying that he was hoping that they would get evacuated. I think he was just being brave. I think at that point they all knew that wouldn't happen. I love my brother and I miss him very much. But he was a victim. He went to work and he was doing his job. And it's terrible that this happened and we miss him so much. But these other people, these men and women, they were doing their jobs that they were getting paid to do. And they still chose to risk their lives to try to save my brother and all these other people. And how courageous is that? How heroic, how wonderful. It's their families I really admire.
The importance of remembering those who were victims and who made such sacrifices was also highlighted.
The people that sacrificed their lives and even others who have sacrificed their health who responded to this incident, they're not the only victims in this circumstances. Their family members live and breathe the sacrifice every moment of their lives since that day when they lost their fathers or mothers, brothers and sisters, children and parents. They live and breathe it every day, and it's important for the rest of society to acknowledge that and to sympathize with them in regards to the sacrifice that, that their family members gave to us.
The MC at the launch, John MacArthur, President and Chief Executive Officer of the Field Museum of Natural History in Chicago, stressed how the exhibition tells the story of the events as they unfolded.
So many stories are told this way through photography, and what Nicola has done is to capture a moment over those 48 hours of what was happening and to have the opportunity to share that with the people of Chicago, many of whom 10 years ago were tiny babies or not even born yet. So we've got the responsibility to share this story, not only to remind people who were here and knew about this, but also to share this story with those kids who have been born since that time. So it was a natural for us to do this wonderful exhibition. And one of the great tragedies of this new century, but also one of the great stories of hope and reconciliation and revival. And it's just a great privilege for us to do, have the opportunity through Paul and Nicola's work to do what we do best, which is to share stories, complicated, in this case, tragic story of the first responders.
Paul McCormick was among the many brave police officers who helped New York during the attacks and in their aftermath, while McLean took thousands of photographs around the city. The couple, now married, created Ground Zero 360 by weaving McLean's images with McCormick's story in a personal way.
With the reception we received here in Chicago and in Dublin, there's so many people want to come and share their thoughts from 9/11. As I said earlier, there's people that lost family members that come in here, and they just, it's a vehicle for them to express themselves. And the response has been just truly amazing. And we would like to take this, you know, across Ireland and across America. And it's something we're very proud of.
The exhibition at the Field Museum runs until January the 2nd. More information on the exhibition can be obtained from www.groundzero360.org. Chris Ashmore for Wallace Media.